I'm John Rotten, and do you do?
Hello, I'm John McGeoch, and this is Ted Cho.
New guy.
I'm Alan.
And there's Brucey Bruce, the drummer.
Yeah, yeah.
Public Image have been around for more than 10 years, but for many they've never scaled the heights of John Lydon's previous combo, the Sex Pistols. But Lydon's hoping that the single, Disappointed, and the slightly mellower sound of the new album, Nine, will change all that.
We spent a lot of time writing these songs and perfecting them before we went anywhere near a studio to record them. I think that's the main effort of our work, isn't it?
Yes. When you can sum it up like this, I know what I like, and John does what he likes.
So there.
Peel was formed with all sorts of revolutionary ideas. They would direct their own videos, they would manage themselves. The band's lineup would change to accommodate different musicians. Of these, only the last has come true. The latest recruit to the Peel fold is guitarist John McGeoch, formerly of Magazine and the Banshees. Is Lydon disillusioned that his more utopian plans didn't work out?
It's an emotion most people feel or have to experience at one point in their life, or sometimes several. Friends do let you down, and it causes a great deal of grief. That doesn't mean to say you shouldn't have friends, you just should pick them a little bit more wisely. Experience has taught all of us this, and we dedicate this song to all our ex-managers.
No future!
The most notable of those ex-managers, and the one against whom Lydon directs most of his venom, is Malcolm McLaren, whose nose for the next big thing has led him to New York and his current passion, voguing. How does the boy who proclaimed no future for the dinosaurs of rock and roll view a chart that still seems full of those very same dinosaurs?
There's nothing wrong with that if there were young people also doing something, but the trouble is at the moment that the younger generations are very, very apathetic and lazy, and they just don't seem to be doing anything. I think it's very bad for music, because it's created that situation where it does appear to be just a load of old fogies on CD.
Now married and with three homes, one in Los Angeles, John Lydon would seem to have left the so-called punk ethic far behind him. As Peel prepare for a new tour, Rapido asked him whether what he's doing now has anything in common with what he was doing then.
There's only one consistent factor in my life, and that would be barefaced honesty. I say exactly what I mean. I don't mess people about, and I don't believe in lies. That's all you could expect from anybody, really.
However revolutionary punk may have seemed at the time, it didn't do any lasting damage to the careers of the supergroups it sought to challenge. Bands like Pink Floyd, Genesis, Fleetwood Mac, and the Rolling Stones are still doing very nicely. But Lydon's still doing his bit to shake up the status quo.
But they're dominating now because there's nothing challenging apart from me and a few others. I can't do any more than what I'm doing. I'm not God, and I don't have all the answers.
So explain why you say you're challenging.
Just by being around, just by existing, just by our music. It's completely new. It's unlike anything you've ever heard. That's a challenge enough. What more do you want?